What's up, guys? We're here at Metroflex Gym with my boy Brandon. Today we're gonna hit some legs. We're gonna do a hamstring focus, and then dive in at the very end doing some quads. But we're gonna stick to a hypertrophy range, about 12 reps, 10 to 15 in that rep range. Focus on the blood flow, and really focusing on the contraction. So a lot of times people are not using their hamstrings. They're actually using a lot of their lower back or other accessory muscles. So that's why usually people have underdeveloped hamstrings. So today we're gonna start off and we're gonna do the lying leg curl. With that, I'm gonna have Brandon really focus on squeezing his butt together into the pad as hard as he can while he's curling his legs up. And I'm actually, when if you have a partner, this is great. But as a partner, you wanna actually help him get to his full contraction, because a lot of times people cannot bring their feet all the way to full contraction. So what I'm gonna do is actually help by pushing the pad forward to help allow him to fully bring up his legs. So we're gonna do full first set here. So he's gonna squeeze his butt together, driving his hips into the pad, and he's gonna bring his legs up. And I'm gonna help by bringing the pad as far forward so he can really contract fully. And with that, you're gonna have his feet stay pretty much neutral. You could play around with it by pointing your feet up, but I like to just kind of keep it neutral. You just focus on squeezing your butt into the pad and contracting. Your feet neutral. Butt, butt, glutes, glutes, glutes. Up, up, good, good. You notice how he's doing a slow eccentric. Good. He's doing a slow eccentric, meaning on the way down, he's going slow so he can use that muscle to develop it. So he's feeling the contraction rather than just throwing around the weight. And if you throw around the weight, that's when your lower back starts to be engaged a lot, when you're throwing around the weight and you're not really focused on the hamstrings. So I'm gonna hit a set at the very end. After this, we'll do three working sets, and then the last set I'm gonna throw it up, or throw it, switch it up, and we'll show you guys something to do as a finisher for this exercise. So we're at the fourth set. I like to implement some different strategy for the fourth set when you're already fatigued. We've got a lot of blood flow in our hamstrings right now. So what we're gonna do is do three reps, and then on the third rep, he's gonna contract as hard as he can, and then I'm gonna push him down and he's gonna resist me on the way down. Check this out, try this out when you're on your last set of a certain muscle group. So try that out. It's super difficult. It's really gonna just flame up your hamstrings and it should hurt like hell. Try it out. All right, so now we're gonna do more of a vertical leg press where you're pushing straight up and down. We're gonna push our butts a little more towards the wall. So then we're gonna try and hit more of our hamstrings, glutes, by pressing through our heels, actually rotating our feet and our knees out. This is a great one. I just tried it before we got on camera here. And definitely the stretch is really good. You wanna make sure that on the way down that you're not going so far down that your lumbar spine, your back is rotating, your hips are lifting off the pad. You wanna keep those planted. So you're just going in your range of motion for what you can do for your hamstrings and your legs in general. So anyways, we're gonna do this. Do sets of, what do you think, Brand? 10 to 12?
Yeah.
10 to 12, and then we'll keep you guys updated.
What's really cool, actually I wanted to put another point in here, is you see how this platform is slightly angled up this way instead of being flat? That's gonna allow the range of motion with his dorsiflexion and plantar flexion and everything, so he can actually press through his heels a little better, come down a little better with his hamstrings to stretch him out at the bottom here. And then you notice that his feet are all the way up at the top of the platform rather than pushed back, as well as his butt. His head is off the pad here because he's so tall, for one. But also, what that is going to do, moving your body up, it's going to allow him to be more on that posterior chain and push through his heels to activate his hamstrings, his glutes, instead of being so far forward. So, Brandon, if you scoot down, if he was down there and put your legs up, see how much more underneath the platform is almost over right here rather than over his glutes. So then it's going to be driving more knee, more quad engagement right here like that. See how he squats, his knees go so far down into his chest? That's going to be a lot more quads. Okay, you're good, Brandon.
Yeah.
But anyways, that's a little bit of difference when you guys are doing a platform of any kind, regular leg press or inverted like this. Kind of take into account the stance on the platform, for one. So bringing your feet a little higher on the platform like he just did right there. And also where your placement is with your core and your back and your glutes and everything, of the line of motion. Because if he scoots up more on the pad, just scoot up, Brandon, other way. Go all the way up the other way, yeah. So if he goes like that, and that was, now the center of mass and everything's gonna be going straight up over his glutes, and his hamstring's gonna be more stretched out and engaged. So take that into consideration. Let's do the next set.
So now we're going to use this back extension machine. We're going to focus on hamstrings. And how we're going to do that is by stabilizing our core and not throwing and lifting our chest back super hard to engage more of our lower back. But instead, we're going to really drive our hips by squeezing our butt together into the pad and then coming up only so far to just focus on tension on the hamstrings rather than going all the way up and focusing on our lower back. So what I mean by that is setting this up is super important. If this is too high, then you're not gonna get a good hamstring stretch. You're just gonna be worried about your back, your lower back. For example, if I had this thing super high, watch me get on here. If my hips are like right here, if I go down, like right here, this is what's gonna be used. Not as much on your hamstrings. Okay? And we don't want to be focusing on our lower back, we want to be focused on our hamstrings. So what I'm going to do is bring this down. It's about this height, so that I hang off the side a little more. So now my legs are hanging over, and I'm going to go down. You can actually see. Pressing as much force as you can through your heels and what's called externally rotating your feet. So it's like you're screwing your feet into the ground. And doing that, pointing your toes out slightly, is going to really help engage, keep the tension on the hamstring. So go ahead and try that out. And as you progress, start adding a weight, a plate, putting on top and holding it on the way down, or using bands for progressive tension adding to each set. All right, so we're just gonna finish up with some calves. Just do the standing calf raise machine. Pretty simple. Walk it like I'm talking. Done here at Metroflex Gym doing some legs, hamstring focused stuff. I added a little bit of calves at the end like you guys saw. But try those exercises out. Try those different sets on your fourth set doing force failure stuff or having your partner apply force and you're resisting it. All that kind of stuff is little tiny tweaks, but I really only do it on my last set, not my working sets. I would only really go to failure maybe on your last set of maybe you're doing those hamstring curls. Don't go to failure every single time, especially when you're first just getting new to lifting. But as time goes on, you're trying to find different strategies to get that little edge. You know, use what we did today, go to failure, do all that kind of stuff, and I hope that helps. We'll see you guys next time.